Assembly Speaker Thandi Modise on Zoom.
President Ramaphosa, President Mbeki, President Mlangeni, Ntate Buthelezi, comrades, ladies and gentlemen. We are gathered today in a very rare occasion to celebrate one of our own. Our father, a leader, a former member of parliament, a former political prisoner, and a golfer of note. We celebrate you, Sir Barangwe Sabato. We celebrate you, Dr. Mokiti Andrew Mlangeni. Ntate Mlangeni, you and your comrades, the Rivonia trialists, and all those who came after you motivated us to join the struggle and to stay on no matter what. Your names, your leadership, your courage invoked deep within us the commitment to stay on and to fight until we achieved emancipation in our lifetime. In the military camps of the ANC, your names reverberated in song and in poem. Your bravery, sometimes we imagined that Comrade Pifo and Pashe were imagining. Whatever it is that they told us about you pushed us to the limits as we tried to walk in the footsteps of you who came before us in military. We want to say that in the streets of our townships, in small groups, in the defiance marches of our people, your sacrifice motivated, your sacrifice endured. From Kholihlahla to Tate Sisulu, to Omgov, to Mdala, to Goldberg, and to the youngest pair, you and Kathrada, you crept and stayed in our hearts. Our mothers did not let us be. They reminded us of you. They reminded us of a duty to stay on course to liberate not only you from prison, but to ourselves and to our futures. They reminded us that it was important for us to stay together, to fight together, so that we can tomorrow see it. As one of the first MPs in post-apartheid South Africa, you were members of parliament. You gave us leadership. You gave us clear directions for our constitutional democracy. Your leadership was clear. Parliament was about the people. Parliament is about the protection and the promotion of rights for all. It must be about service. It must be about selflessness. It must be dependable. It must be service with humility. That vision, that instruction that you gave us, is what sustained most of us to continue staying on, to ask the awkward questions in the attempt to make sure that even the smallest voice in the streets of Soweto or Dryhards are heard. You have played your role well, Ntate Mlangeni, for us, the younger ones, to follow on. You have taught us that we must always look at the other side of the argument. You have taught us to look for reason, to mediate. You have also showed us that being active in and amongst our communities is a better way to involve the community in the decision-making of government. You have met a lot of people through your golf, something that some of us will never do in 100 years. Today we say this happy birthday to Ntate Mlangeni, fighting a war against the coronavirus that has already taken 800 lives. I trust that your discipline, Ntate Mlangeni, will enable us to stay together as a country to wage a war against this coronavirus. I want to think that your teachings in parliament will make sure that we are watchful, that we will not allow any space for corruption or any unchecked authority to erode what we have established as a people in our human rights culture. We must be committed to good governance in your name. We want to assure you that Parliament will continue to follow your examples. And just in this, I want to say to Minister Nathi Mthethwa, I do hope you heard the impassioned cry of Andrew Mlangeni on the day of Sona this year. Please heed the cry of the former political prisoners minister. Comrade Andrew, last year on the occasion of the Cape Peninsula University of Technology bestowing on you and Comrade Dennis Goldbeck honorary doctorates, you confided in some of us that you felt like you were turning 30. And I wasn't surprised at all, because I know you, how active you are. I know how youthful you are. And I take this opportunity, Comrade Andrew, to wish you a very happy 31st birthday. Leave the 95 alone. But before I finish, my leader, there is a small committee that you established after the passing of Mejun. When you were receiving too many invitations from volunteers to fill up the vacancy left by our mother. Now, Comrade Nosivue and I have noticed that our finger wagging duty has not been used much in the last few years. And we were wondering whether you are considering to disband this little committee. Should we step down, Plegas? We want to say Pila Morena, Repilele, Pila Morena, as a living example, not only of your family, not only of the ANC, but of this country and all those who care about it. Happy birthday, Comrade Andy. Happy birthday, my father. Happy birthday, a friend. Happy birthday, a marriage counselor. Repilele, Daddy. Kia leboga.